Hello friends, welcome to the channel, the Dynamic Resource Forum. Now in today's video, I am going to talk about the impacts of the First World War in India. In what way the First World War had a greater impact for developing the feeling of nationalism among the people of India. Already we have discussed when the war started, what were the effects of the war and so on. Now, let us understand, during this period, during the period of the First World War, India was under British rule, and since Britain, it was the part and parcel of the First World War, naturally, whenever the war breaks out, the expenses increases. And there was a huge increase in defense expenditure. And this defense expenditure, it was to be met from the Indian economy. As a result of it, in order to meet the expenses that is going to be incurred for the First World War, the British government, they increased the taxes. They imposed the various taxes on the Indian people. The income taxes, it was introduced. The custom duties, the import duties and the export duties, it was hiked like anything. And in addition to that, to add the misery of the people, during this period, there was a great crop failure. The people, they were suffering like anything. They had faced several hardships. But the British government, they were so cruel that they did not revert back. Rather, they went on imposing their policies without any consideration. And one more thing, they had done it, that they started recruiting the Indians, the Indian youth, forcibly. There is a terminology, force recruitment. Now, force recruitment means recruiting the Indian youth in the British Army forcibly and sending them to fight against the forces on behalf of the British government during the First World War. And due to this reason, there was a resentment among the people. And people hoped that after the end of the First World War, all their miseries, all their hardship will come to an end. But this did not happen. Generally in CBSE examination, they ask the questions, what were the effects of the First World War in India? Now, these were the effects that the people, they had to face the hardship. There was no consideration from the British side. And the British people, they started recruiting the Indian youth forcibly. So generally, they ask the question, what do you understand by the term force recruitment? Now, in this chapter, basically, India's national movement. This chapter deals with the Gandhian era. The arrival of Mahatma Gandhi, or the active participation of Mahatma Gandhi in India's national movement. You know, Mahatma Gandhiji, he returned from South Africa on 9th January 1915. And after his arrival in India, he started taking part in the India's national movement. And Mahatma Gandhi, as you know, the father of our nation, he has given the great principle to the entire world. That advocated the philosophy of Satyagraha. Now here, generally the question is asked in the examination. What do you understand by the term Satyagraha? Satyagraha means, here it is, in Hindi what we call it, Satyagraha. Satya ke liye agraha karna. That means, it emphasizes the power of truth and the need to search for the truth. And if you are right on your part, there is no need to use any violence. And in this method, Mahatma Gandhiji believed that the people could be united. They could fight against the British imperialism. And your struggle, it would be against the oppressor. And if you are right on your path, there is no weapon that is required to gain the freedom. There is no other weapon that is required to fight against the injustice. Mahatma Gandhi advocated this novel method of agitation, which is called as Satyagraha. I hope The concept of Satyagraha is very clear to you, and through this method only Mahatma Gandhiji had launched this series of Satyagrahas, the series of movements against the British government, which we are going to discuss about it in the subsequent videos. And in what way he was successful? In fact, this is the novel method that he has given to the entire world, that is the concept of the truth and the non-violence. And even today, Mahatma Gandhi, he is considered as the apostle of truth and the non-violence. I hope the concept is very clear to you, and in what way the First World War, it helped the Indian people to develop the feeling of nationalism among India. So during part 3, we shall be discussing the Gandhian era in the meantime. So during this period only, Mahatma Gandhi, he arrived on the scene of the India's national freedom struggle. And what all the movements Mahatma Gandhi had carried it out, we shall be discussing the same in the part 3 of my video. And I hope you understood the terminology, the force recruitment, and also the effects of the First World War on the Indian national scenario. If you like the video, please share it and subscribe it. Thank you.